If you're in the mood for a classic cookie recipe, but you don't want to turn on your oven, then you're in the right place. Today, I'm going to show you how to make a classic peanut butter and chocolate, no bake oatmeal cookie. You're not going to want to miss it. Hey everyone, it's Dorothy with crazyforcrust.com and welcome back to my kitchen. Today I am making those classic no-bake cookies that you remember from grandma or your mom's kitchen. They're chocolate with peanut butter inside and lots of oats. You cook them on the stovetop and then they set kind of like candy or fudge. So no baking needed. You can make them all summer or all year long. They're so, so good. We love these. I'm gonna show you how to make them and some tips for success. For more delicious desserts and easy recipes, be sure to subscribe to my channel. Now let's get in the kitchen. Making these cookies is super fast. It's kind of like when you're making candy or fudge because we're cooking it on the stove and then we're gonna scoop it immediately. So it's really important to have all of your ingredients measured out and ready to go. Have your cookie sheets lined with like parchment paper or wax or silicone baking mats and ready to go. So everything's ready when you start and that way, because it's a very quick process once it gets going. Start with a half of a cup of unsalted butter. I like to dice it because it melts faster that way. And melt it in a medium saucepan over medium heat. Once it's melted, add a half of a cup of nonfat milk, a quarter of a cup of unsweetened cocoa powder, and 2 cups of granulated sugar. Whisk that together until it's smooth, and then I switch to a spatula and continue stirring occasionally until it comes to a boil. It'll start to simmer, and then it will become a rolling boil. Now, a lot of the recipes for these cookies online just say cook for X amount of minutes or just boil for this long. And sometimes when you do it and you're not paying close enough attention, maybe it's not boiling enough, it's not hot enough, then your cookies don't set up and you just have a mess, you don't have cookies. So my secret tip for making these cookies foolproof every single time is using an instant read thermometer or a candy thermometer. This is a thermopen. It is, you can buy it on the thermopen site. I will link it below, but you can also find cheaper versions of this on Amazon. I highly recommend an instant read thermometer instead of a candy thermometer, because this is super versatile. I use this for making candy, making these cookies. I use this also whenever I'm cooking meat to check the temperature. It's really a great tool for your kitchen if you don't want to have this and a candy thermometer. I often find that candy thermometers are kind of not super accurate either, which is why I absolutely love this. And the thermopen is my favorite one because it's super accurate. There's no battery or anything needed, so you don't have to worry about when you wash it and all that sort of thing. But again, you can buy the cheaper versions on Amazon.
Once it's reached 230 degrees, you're gonna remove the pan from the heat and add in a half of a cup of creamy peanut butter. Stir until it's melted and then add 1 teaspoon of vanilla and 1/4 teaspoon of salt.
And if you don't like peanut butter, you can also substitute Nutella or Biscoff. In my upcoming cookbook, I actually have a Biscoff version of this with not even any chocolate. So these are super, super simple, super versatile.
Once it's all mixed together, add 3 cups of quick cooking oats.
Now, if you only have old-fashioned oats, you don't have quick cooked oats in your kitchen, don't worry, you can still make these cookies. You can make your own quick oats by just popping the old-fashioned oats into a blender or a food processor, pulse a few times, and you have quick oats. I'm gonna link that up here. I have a post all about with all the sorts of information about that on my website.
Then use a 1 or 2 tablespoon cookie scoop or 2 spoons to drop spoonfuls onto your prepared cookie sheet.
Now, once you have all your cookies scooped on the baking sheets, these just need to set. Usually they won't take very long to set to like a soft set, a couple hours till they're nice and firm. You can also pop these in the refrigerator to get them to set up faster, especially if it's the middle of summer, it's really hot in your house, you might wanna pop these in the refrigerator, but they'll set no problem, especially if you've used the thermometer trick. They should set up and they taste like a chewy peanut butter cup. I absolutely love these cookies and I know that you're gonna love them too. You can see that they're soft when you break them in half and they're all chewy from those oats. These are so delicious. I know you're gonna love them as much as we do. Leave me a comment and let me know what your favorite no-bake recipe is, and keep watching for even more cookie recipes.